All right. And share this. We're gonna go in. We're gonna talk about some of the hot topics, but we're gonna talk about the stuff that they're not even going to touch. All right, especially in the mainstream, we're gonna hit on that stuff that they're not even gonna touch. They're not gonna touch it with a 10-foot pole. All right. Okay, so some of you might have an idea what I'm talking about, but yeah, it's time. And this is how we feel. This is how the Moors feel. This is how it feels when you know what's going on, when you're on it. You know about your nationality. You know what's popping, and you hear the vice president, former vice president Joe Biden, on TV talking to Charlemagne the God, saying if you support Trump over him, over voting for him, voting for the Democrats, you ain't black. And it's got all the so-called black folks in an uproar. You know, some of them, you know, they don't know what to do, cause they so used to supporting Democrats, and they, you know, they don't know what to do. But then the other ones, they upset, cause they like, this is crazy. How's he gonna say that? All right. But Moors know we ain't black anyway. All right. And he said some other stuff in there, something that was real slick, that went by most people. Islam to the brother Donald Lee. Happy Holy Day. All right, but yeah, he slipped something in. He slipped, y'all. He really did, and it's funny because it ain't the whole "you ain't black" thing. That was stupid too. But he said something that went over most people's heads, and we're gonna bring it all. Prophet Noble Drew Ali for bringing us our divine creed and nationality, returning it to us so that our eyes are open, so that we know. And honors to everybody that's sharing this, helping to spread this, because they not, what we about to talk about, they totally skip, but we not skipping over it, because we not scared here. All right, so everybody make sure you subscribe, like, follow the page. If you're on Facebook, you see the stuff in that left-hand corner. We're also on Instagram. All right, get on all those channels if you're on them. All right, so you can get this real news. Trust me, they don't talk about this, but we're gonna talk about it. So we getting started. Peace and blessings to all of you. Make sure the like button and just subscribe to the page. Okay, follow the page, like the page. On that note, we're gonna get started.
Yeah. Hey, 5 on the right, 2 on the left, man. You know what time it is. Yo. We just Moors in America, soared through the shores and endured criminal acts of war on our character. 7 years after the fourth score, no reward. Shout out to the most courageous, they was jumping over barriers. Where does that compare to you? We come from a place where you scared to visit our area. We come from a place where it's scary for good Samaritans. Conquer lower self with a high, follow your regimen. Way before they came, we were gods and now we specimen. Tried to take the light from our eyes, thank God for Edison. Then they put the wool on our eyes. This sin isn't devilish. Sometimes in this face of Harriet, I bet you I'ma carry it. I'm in love with music to the point I want it, so I write messages. Largest spending power, but we still sit at a deficit. Living amongst prejudice, even at our residence. Moors in America, flourishing, excellent. Let's buy up some neighborhoods and groom our own president. Yeah. To you today
to share and get this word out. Like I said, we're going to discuss some of the things that they gloss over, that they're not covering. things that pertain to us, and something that you definitely want to share this with your family so that they can see these things. Because I'm telling you, the eventual elect, I guess you would say, would you call him that? A presidential candidate, Joe Biden, he's on there talking to Charlamagne just because they're Democrat. You know, he wants to know what you could do for his community. And he let him know, he's like, look, if you vote for Trump over me, you ain't black. And he let, you know, he kind of lost. He said that just went over everybody's head. But, you know, I shared the meme and saw some people getting upset about it. A lot, you know, most of our people are still at this place where they just think that for just giving almost brand loyalty to the Democratic Party, just voting Democrat, just because, getting nothing in exchange for it. All right, like absolutely nothing in exchange for it. And they're supposed to, you have no leverage in this type of situation, because the people know, you know, that they get your vote. You just gonna vote for them or not vote at all, but the ones that do, they gonna support Democrats. So they know they don't have to do anything. No leverage at all. It's the most pitiful, lame position in the world, but you know, we keep the prophet out front. But heard of that, I advise you read it. I advise you get all the literature that you can from the prophet Noble Drew Ali and study so that you can gain deeper insight, you know, as to your own liberation or your own salvation. But in political slavery is saying anytime a man or woman fails to or refuses to cast a sacred ballot at the polls, you're not participating in the process of electing the people, you know, choosing the people to help to administrate your society. If you're not placing these people in positions and you know, negotiating with them, and it's an ever going ongoing process. You don't just vote. You're failing yourself, right? It's not hurting them, it's only hurting you. So any man or woman that fails or refuses to cast a ballot at the polls, the sacred ballot, the prophet called it the sacred ballot, they separate themselves from a citizen. For surely this is the one connecting medium for a citizen to his nation. They become no more than belated beasts of burden. All right, that sounds familiar, right? The plight of the so-called African American, beast of burden. There are reasons why certain classes who are more or less independent take no part in politics, since they say they get nothing out of such in the way of material gain. So you have a lot of our people who, I understand where they're coming from, they feel like it don't benefit them anyway. You know, it's not prospering them. So they don't even want to take part. They gave up. And I get that. That makes sense. Political slavery, all right, which is more prevalent among the less independent classes, is that of being forced into one of the nation. So just rewinding back to that, the wording of that, you know, because you have some Moors who's thinking like, oh, we don't vote, we don't do it this, we don't do none of that. Okay, y'all over there, I'm with the prophet. We do vote. We place people in position. Ancient, our ancestors, right here in the Americas. It's based off of their system of governing. The Iroquois was based off of that. Okay? So you can't give credit to the great white man or whatever you want to call him for all of this. Okay? Not taking anything away from them, though. Not saying that they didn't come up with any ideas or change things up. I'm just saying it's built off of us. It's built off of what our ancestors already had up and running, our nation. One other way around, they came into our nation, and then things started to get flipped and changed and expanded and contracted and into the present day construct that it is, that we call the United States of America. But they actually true American citizen. You can't shamed almost into voting a certain, because there were incidents that happened when Trump was running where Steve Harvey met with Trump. Of course, I know, you know, there was a lot of racist stuff and things going on around it, but none of that stuff matters. Emotions aside, you still have to negotiate. You have to have leverage in here. Okay, those of you who do participate, he tries to shame him just for putting pressure on him to answer questions as to what he would do for our community in exchange for that you can be shamed that easily. And he can try to weasel his way out of saying what he's really, that he's, because he has no plans at all for doing anything for the community other than getting some figurehead, maybe, you know, Michelle Obama or the Kamala Harris lady who, like, had this, you know, terrible reputation in the state that she was a representative of for being harsh on our people, trying to lock up as many of our people as possible. You know, he gets somebody like that as a talking head to be his running mate. That is not doing anything for the community, all right? No resources, no anything that's really going to help improve us, right? Nothing that you would throw your support behind somebody for. So he was putting a little bit of pressure, just a little bit, on him. You know, like, okay, what do you have to offer? And he tried to weasel his way out of it, dumbing down the conversations like, okay, if you don't vote for me, you're not black. Like, Trump and them are racist. If you don't vote, and it was insane. And I'm glad Trump and them, they gonna destroy him over that. You know, he's a fool. He's a fool. Okay, I see somebody said he's matching Trump's energy, but no, on the contrary, he is a fool, because if you had the conversation with Trump about what you can do for the community, and if especially if you bring him real questions like, well, this is what we need, then you say, well, nah, I can't do that, but I can do this. He's not going to be like, well, if you don't vote for me, you ain't real. You know what I'm saying? That was whack. That was pitiful. And that's where the conversations and stuff like that, right? She ain't offering anything for you. And then it's like, how can people talking about getting black preachers, the Negro preacher, to get our communities to accept the Planned Parenthood? Okay, so... I mean, that's racist, right? Islam to the sister said that's funded by Gates. Yes, very racist, if you want to say that. That's why I'm saying, who cares? Just like, I can't do that, but I can do this. But it's not just, okay, we voted for her because we've been voting Democrat for years. How that work for you? The Democrats used to be pro-slavery. Get out of here with that mess, okay? And so I see, you know, like I said, just talking about the situation, just to get the dialogue going, hopefully to take this convo in another direction. A lot of people get it, but, you know, don't want to just preach to the choir that already know. Some of the folks who really don't have this understanding, man, they are not trying to get it, okay? And when I say that, I mean, you got people who like this comment on there, who's just going off, like literally going off. You're such an idiot. Someone has to belittle you for supporting Trump or anything or anyone that supports that, what'd she say, Cretan? Closer look, the profile picture, and it's like, wait, hold up. You saying, it seems like I love the oppressor. We love our oppressor. And now you can see why that person has that mentality, okay? Not really about that person though, but this rats have more humane policies. What did the Democrats have for you? Welfare. We got welfare. Always pushing that, right? Aren't they always pushing abortion? Women's rights for abortion. For getting them numbers down. Yeah, you can have some more. Well, get this job. I'm not going to qualify for the housing or for whatever it is that you're getting. You know, it keeps you. You have to prove this is what they're behind. Why not? Why aren't they? Why aren't they behind putting more resources into our communities so that we don't need welfare? You know, helping to empower. Like, why is it so that you can have people who can come here from other countries? They can come from China, Korea, Vietnam, Pakistan, Afghanistan, even from different countries, from Nigeria. They can come from all these places, set up shop in our neighborhoods, owning stores, owning real estate, and we've been there forever. Okay? That's why you got so many people on that system. And they're locking you into that. They don't care. They don't care about bankrupting you. They don't care about keeping you impoverished. They don't care about selling you out. All right? Don't y'all get tired of that? Right? Y'all see the pictures, the people who own in the nail shops and all these stuff, all these places, and they're in the hood. You know? And it's sad. It's pitiful. And giving them your money, right? They own everything that's there, right? Everyone else can come and do it, but it's more difficult, servile position for as long as possible. Okay? And so I understand, like, you know, the people, they think that it's for them, but they keep you locked into mental slavery, literally. Okay? With the fact that you would think someone thinking outside the box and starting to see through this, you think that they're loving their oppressor because they told you what? They told you Trump's racist. He's racist. Meanwhile, they and they do whatever. Tell me you got hot sauce and fried chicken in your pocket. I don't care. All right? You know, into the prison industrial complex just to munch them out. All right? To keep you locked into generational poverty so that you never have anything to pass down and they don't like you and they're treating you harshly. Right? Unfairly, sometimes even killing people for no reason, and they don't even get prosecuted. That's crazy, right? So to support that system, continue supporting it, you're just keeping it going on and on. Some of the things that just said in response, you know, just like obviously just talking about you love your oppressor. I don't even know why they said that, but I super predators, right? She was speaking, supporting the former president, Bill Clinton, her husband, Bills, back in 94. And she was talking about how they need to be extra hard on the so-called African-American youth. These gangbangers. There's anyone else would have immediately, like, you know, would have immediately not accepted that. They would have just, like, then they wouldn't have let that go. But, you know, our people, look at this. These are the type of people that support that. Okay? Just being real. They support that. They don't see anything wrong with it. But like I was saying, it's some stuff that's going to come out. And it's going to blow a lot of people away. The WikiLeaks. You had all these things that were coming out about emails that were being exchanged. People like the Clintons and their aides and associates. All right? And they're all using this weird terminology, talking about pizza. These are the words and things that they use with each other. They even have little symbols in, symbols like there's a triangle inside of a triangle. There's some other symbols that they have that a lot of time these people will get tattooed. Wow. YouTube's hating on us right now. It's okay. I mean, that's what happens sometimes when you speak to they get tattooed on themselves. But come to find out, when you really look at some of these organizations that these same people see, the Clintons, these are just names I'm throwing out there. But for real, people like this started. They have all these foundations that are supposed to be for helping children. And they have these same pedophile symbols in them, right? As the logo. And of course, they're being used as fronts for doing their dirty work. And so some of this stuff got exposed, right? I don't know how they knew. He gets caught and, you know, law enforcement comes in now because it was a child, okay? And so they come in and they get all the see up here with all these pedophiles. And so he has stuff in there from all types of big, important people because he was a congressman. He was in New York City, all right? And he's very close to Hillary Clinton. His wife was at it in a way where it's obvious they're talking about something horrible and terrible. Like some of these words that are up here, like pizza and hot dog, pedophile words for little boys and girls. Hot dog boy, pizza girl, pasta little boy. I mean, it's crazy. It's crazy, okay? But it gets even more messed up than that because you also had Obama while he was in office. Right? He had some party, I guess. I don't know. It says National Pizza Day. He ordered $65,000 worth of pizza and hot dogs for a VIP party at the White House. And he's just saying, hello, some young lawyer type friends of mine hosting an Obama fundraiser at Comet Ping Pong. This is tied into the whole Pizzagate thing. They had this Comet Ping Pong, like, pizza kitty type place in DC, okay, right? And they're always talking about getting pizza and hot dogs. Okay. And so like literally this is like their den or something. And so like, yeah, they for some reason Obama's having a fundraiser there, right? And these people are, this is just a conversation about it, talking about should it be about 150 people. Would you be willing to stop by? He's trying to ask the John Podesta dude to come by. Also saw that you're reading. Yeah. So anyway, this is allegedly like recovered emails too. So this isn't from the Wiener dude. This is from somebody else. The Podesta guy. He's also a guy that's in trouble. Okay. This is another thing I'll share with you too. This is something I haven't confirmed yet. Don't know if this is true or not, but they're saying that because of like security regulations, you know, like Secret Service, you can't just have food coming into the White House, you know? Like, how can that be, right? So it's crazy. Look, a lot of this stuff is gonna come out and people are gonna be shocked and amazed, okay? Angry because she's grimy, like extremely grimy, like they have bodies on them, you know, because she called African-American youth super predators, saying has she apologized now this years later, like way later, when she's running for president now, like 20 some years later, she's running for president against Trump, and some of the Black Lives Matter people try to call her to task on these comments that nobody even puts any pressure on them. Okay, and so they call her to task for it, and she, what are the actual, you know, what are the actual security measures regarding the White House and food? But it's still crazy, it's still weird that he ordered hot dog and pizza, $65,000 worth, you know, to come in from Chicago. This one likes-
And or a
like,
public service of your television
this
provider,
is not,
C-SPAN. Created by cable.
It's not a conspiracy.
The fourth challenge is to take, but we can see it already makes a difference. Because if we have more police interactory generals that we have in our country, he's already proven that he knows how to interdict drugs because of his command of the South American activity on behalf of the United States. But General McCaffrey will make a big difference. And I believe it is now time for all of us to know what we can do individually to be part of this anti-crime, anti-gangs, anti-drug effort.
So about the food, I'm just reading this off the internet. You can't bring in outside food with the strictness rivaled only by movie theaters. You're not allowed to take outside food into the White House when visiting cooks, chefs cook there. They can't bring pre-prepared sauces, as all ingredients must be obtained by the kitchen staff through secret and secure sources. Okay? And I'm getting this article. I don't see the source on it. But you could look that up, you know, just to check to see if that's true. It's on this website called Thrillist.com. But the cabinet being poisoned. So, you know, that's what this is saying. I don't know how the whole, you know, I heard that stuff about Trump too. You know, he ordered like fast food for the teams and stuff that came. I don't know how that worked. You probably know they had to eat it somewhere else. The chefs have to get it. Okay, so if this is true, all right, which makes sense, why is President Obama getting $65,000 worth of hot dogs and pizza flown in to the White House from Chicago? Even if that wasn't true, it still don't make sense. But this is true, right? Doesn't make any sense. Unless something else is going on. I mean, the whole world, the right for women to abort their babies. They're always pushing for this. This is huge for them. They're also big on gun control. Why is they want to get guns? And it's not even really about us. They really want to get the guns from all these Europeans that own them. Because they own most of the guns in the country. They don't want an uprising. Okay? It's just really simple. That's why every time there's a mass shooting, like there was just one like 2 or 3 days ago in Arizona at a shopping mall. Every time there's a mass shooting, they come right away talking about we need to get them guns. You know, sometimes they'll just be like, oh, we need to get all the automatic rifles. Look, they pulled it off in Canada. They, You know, Eric Garner, you have all these people being killed, choked, shot and killed, beaten by the police. There's a movement called Black Lives Matters. What does President Obama do? He signs the Blue Alert Law to protect police. Basically, aligning himself with this racist movement called Blue Lives Matters. It was just like a counter movement, just a counter one. It even criminals know, you know, that you potentially gonna have hell. Don't love you. You know what I'm saying? Law. You don't have to protect them like that. It's just common sense. All right. Even some stone cold killers who will kill anyone. They know killing a police officer not the same as killing someone else. Why? Because they're going to be more motivated to get revenge for that. Saying how like Obama angers, you know, or lets, you know, black people down by signing this stuff while the Black Lives Matter protests are going on. It's like, come on. Slap in the face. That was crazy. Okay? And it really happened. It's so crazy that, you know, something like that would happen, right? But yeah, it really happened. Okay, and so everybody should have been angry. Should have been up in arms about it. But, you know, a lot of people just felt comfortable, so they let it go. All right, but in reality, this was horrible, and that was just a slap in the face, and they do this all the time. Like, literally, they do this all the time. So, you know, this brings us right on that, okay? But what I'll tell you what is messed up is what he said.
It's really hard time, I apologize.
You can't do that to black media.
Voting racks, 25 years. I have a record that is second to none. The NAACP has endorsed me every time I've run.
Now look, okay, you know, everybody was upset, you know, like what he said was ignorant. You know, he's just implying he's trying to shame him because he put a little bit of pressure on him. You know, and I'm not faulting Charlemagne the guy, dude. I mean, you know, he wasn't really coming at him hard, but I guess he did what he could. Probably had to submit whatever questions he got for him, you know, ahead of time. He can't really go hard, but he didn't. All he did was say, hey, we want to know what you could do for us. Put a little pressure on him. He didn't like it. So he's like, well, look, if you don't vote for me, you're not even black. Just trying to shame the people to keep doing what they, it hasn't worked for you then, it ain't gonna work for you now. But then after that, you know, Charlemagne didn't back down. He just let it be known that, hey, I'm not just blindly supporting anyone, right? He said, I want to know what you could do. Know what he could do. He's like, well, look, I renewed the Voting Rights Act for another 25 years. And that went over everybody's head. That went over everybody's head. Let me see if we could get this up on the screen. He said that, and that was a big deal, y'all. That really was. Okay? That was a big deal. We're gonna get this up here for everybody. But that went over everybody's head. And, you know, to me, that
was so much. That's really our time. I apologize.
You can't do that to black media. You
can't do that to white media and black media because my wife has to go on at 6 o'clock.
Okay.
Oh,
that's really what this is all about. He said he renewed the Voting Rights Act for another 25 years. This is the great thing that he's done for our people. Now, that is asinine. That is foolish, is crazy, and it goes over everyone's head. Because most people don't know what the Voting Rights Act is. They don't know that it only applies to us. All right? Why are we, the so-called African American, the so-called black people that used to be called colored, that used to be called Negroes, why are we the only people who have a question? You know, hopefully he can do it. Maybe put his career on the line and do that. Because they ask these real questions. Even so, you know, just this like cavalier attitude, like, oh, well, you have just enough so that if you're not paying attention, you think you have the same rights. But all the injustice, you're not black if you don't vote for me. Yeah, forget that. I don't care. I'm not black. we're Moorish American. I'm Moorish American. The creation, it was something that was created by the Europeans who came over here and colonized your people, right? They came over here and colonized their ancestors. They created these terms to disconnect us from our true heritage. Why would you want to go along with that? There's no pride in that. Ain't no pride in that. That has nothing to do with our skin color. It has nothing to do with our culture and who we really are. It has everything to do with this dog. That's all you get. Even in your own neighborhoods, you can't police yourself. You can't go. How come you have people, foreigners, people who come over here from all over the world, and they get their citizenship and they can vote? Cut off. This was like the only place where you could see that part of the interview. This website right here. And this is like for the UK, sun.uk. Maybe that's why. Everything else aimed at the United States, like CNN and all that stuff, it cuts off right before he says that. Go look it up yourself. I'm not making this up. They cut it off right before that part. I mean, it's crazy. And that is the thing that should have everybody up in arms. That's what everybody should be upset about. I would say, look, but for those who are just saying you're not black if you don't vote for me, hey, that's just common sense, right? First off, it's stupid to just support these Democrats, these Republicans, these anyones without putting any pressure on them, right? And also, it's dumb to have party loyalty. You have no leverage, right? If we're just Republican, we're going to vote Republican no matter what. That's stupid. That means they don't really have to do it. Our people as a collective, you know, have to be organized, have to be, you know, able to say, okay, this is what we're going to do. This one, he took part in the renewal of our right to vote, him and Obama. They signed off on it. Obama's like, yeah, Latusha and they have these rights, and it's just their God-given rights. So the people should be asking, why doesn't Latusha have you up in arms and you know, wanting change, really wanting, you know, to do something to actually change all of this. Because that's crazy, man. That's insane. And I can't believe he said that on TV. I'm glad he did. But like I said, they don't even play that over here. Okay, you could go check it out for yourself. CNN and all that stuff, they do not play it. They simply don't play it. Put it off right there. And you saw they cut that interview off too right after he said that. They're like, okay, you have to go for real now. You have to get off of here. Okay, they had these people, all right? And if people aren't gonna wake up off of that, you know, I don't know what to tell you, all right? Because
do that to white media and black media, because my wife has to go on at 6 o'clock.
Okay. Come see us when you come to New York, VP Biden.
I will.
It's a long way until November. We got more questions.
You got more questions, but I tell you, if NAACP's endorsed me every time I've run, you ain't black.
It don't have nothing to do with Trump. It has to do with the fact I want something for my community. I would love to see
you. Take a look at my record, man. I extended the voting rights 25 years. I have a record that is second to none. The NAACP.
It has to do with the fact I want something for my community. I would love to see
you. Take a look at my record, man. I extended the voting rights 25 years. I have a record that is second to none.
Make sure you share this video.
My community. I would love to see
you. Take a look at my record, man. I extended the voting rights 25 years.
He extended the Voting Rights Act 25 years. He's not going to explain what that means. It only applies to the so-called black people.
My community. I would love to see
Take
you.
Take a look at my record, man. I extended the Voting Rights 25 years. I have a...
I'm not making this stuff up, all right? Look that up. I advise everybody watching this video, go look that up. See what the Voting Rights Act is. See why it only applies to you and why you have to get your rights to vote every 25 years. Look that up. Okay? Okay, somebody asked in the chat, shout out to Mia, okay, why this is actually a thing. Because it's ridiculous. And I'm glad you did catch that. Okay, you're smart. Because a lot of people, that went right over their head. Okay? But this is ridiculous. You know, and it makes no sense. And, like, you know, there's really no reason why our rights to vote should apply to us. All right? Why? Why is it that we're the only ones? Why are we singled out? That's crazy. It doesn't make sense unless you know what's really going on. All right? And this is the stuff that they're not going to teach you anywhere else. The only place really where you're going to get information like this would be from the Morris Science Temple of America. All right? Like, plain and simple. The only place you're going to get this type of info is going to be from the Morris Science Temple of America, because, you know, everywhere else, they're going to give you, like, the watered-down version of history. But in reality, late 1700s, mid-1700s, you had things rolling, balls rolling, moving into place to get the indigenous Americans to take on a status that disconnected them from their true heritage, their true connection to the land, and to their ancestors who were civilized, who had government. Remember, I said earlier, this off peace and also other, you could say, Indian documents or whatever, okay? But the actual government was in place. We had that. This is all based off of it, okay? So the Negro, which is what our, you know, maybe even your grandparents were called, depending on how old or young you are, some people on their birth certificate, it says Negro. Some people it says colored. You had the Jim Crow laws, which further, you know, solidified this, you know, social political status of this Negro in place. Sentence, it does not embrace the free inhabitants of Africa, such as the Egyptians, Moors, or the Negro Asiatic, such as the Lascars. And the Lascars are like the dark-skinned people from modern-day India, right? The ancestors. There are also other literature, other acts. Negro is incapable of having descendants, all right? And it's incapable, actually, of having ancestors. It doesn't come from a civilized people. It's Nilius Filius. If you look up Nilius Filius, you'll see that this Latin term is talking about something that's like a ward of the state, something that is an orphan. And that is what put out is future slaves. This is my interpretation or my wording, but this is what it's saying. Okay? And like I was saying, some people will say, well, that was the 1700s and the 1800s and the 1900s. Like they did then. Times have changed. It's just like they can't call you Negroes anymore. They used to say that openly. Not even that long ago. Right? In the 1960s, they were still calling people Negroes. Now you have Federal Directive 15. Comes from an original people somewhere. Extremely questionable. Okay? This is not harmless. This isn't just used for the census. This isn't just used for like your job applications or whatever where they ask for your race. This is getting used across the board as Federal Directive 15 defining the major ethnic groups or races or whatever they want to call it, as they say racial categories. Like it says here, the legal definitions for race. Why is black the only race defined by the same word? Circular definitions are invalid. Who are the black racial groups in Africa? The human race in law, is it? Prove it. The burden of proof is on them because we have laws that are removing it from the family of humans or defining it as something that's not connected. We see how, you know, federally, it's something that isn't even from an original people somewhere. It's not even a part of the family of humans. Okay? That is ridiculous. Okay, and back to the question. I hope that helped, though. But you're saying, okay, let's see. Because black African Americans, legally, socially, politically, aren't even connected to the family of humans. The Constitution doesn't even apply. Anything that we have, it's coming from civil rights. It's coming from different acts and laws, just, you know, that were afforded to us. We shouldn't even need any of that. The Constitution should be good enough. Okay? And this is why they can just kill the people, and sometimes they don't even have to go to trial. Okay? Don't even go to trial, not even facing prison time. This is why. And this is also why the right to be renewed every 25 years, and it's only us. It's not just racism. I'm not saying that there's no racism behind it. I'm just saying it's deeper than that. That's the dumbed down reason. The real reason is because we are in this stupid position that we need to get out of, because they're obviously not gonna fix it. Okay? you can't expect the people who or the people who maybe possibly descended from the ones who put you in that. I mean, they've had all this time to do something about it, and they haven't done anything. They haven't taught us about this. They're not teaching it right now. They don't even. That's what needs to be discussed. That's what we need to move on. That's why I'm saying, yeah, the only place you're really going to get this information is here. He's not talking about all Americans. He's not talking about the right of all Americans to vote being renewed for another 25 years. He's talking about you, Charlotte, because maybe it'll help open up dialogue and people open their eyes. He should have kept it all the way real, because that's what he did. And that's why, you know what I'm saying, this is crazy. And, hey, they're going to tell the truth, okay? A lot of people just, they have no clue. And it's time for people to start waking up, man, okay? We can't be this sleep right now in this day and time, okay? Like, the situation is crucial. It is very crucial. There's no joke. I mean, there's nothing funny about this. It's just, it's time, man. So, for everybody in here, peace and love. We're going to go ahead and shut this down. Make sure y'all share this. Help get this information out there. That's really what it's about, man. The man said that he renewed our rights to vote, and we should just be thankful for that. Be thankful for that, you slaves. He renewed your rights to vote for another 25 years. What you want? What else you want? What else you want from him? All right? So that's crazy, but that's where we at right now. So on that note, peace and love, everybody. We out. Islam, Islam, Islamism.
Yeah. Hey, 5 on the right, 2 on the left, man. You know what time it is. Yo. Soared through the shores and endured criminal acts of war on our character. 7 years after the 4th score, no reward. Shout out to the most courageous, they was jumping over barriers. Where does that compare to you? We come from a place where you scared to visit our area. We come from a place where it's scary for good Samaritans. Heavy luggage we carrying, babies having babies, it's crazy. La ilaha illa Allah, body and buried in. Laughing at you clowns like ha ha, dodging. imagine the Nephilim. Conquer lower self with a high. Follow your regimen. Way before they take the light from our eyes. Thank God for Edison. Then they put the wool on our eyes. It's so embarrassing. Now we travel frequently. We should invest in Sheraton. All of us got gold on our bodies whenever we stepping in. Screaming Ramadan, Mubarak, training the flesh again. Wishing we could move as a unit just like the Mexicans. Dodging all the foods with estrogen, synthetic medicines. Also face a Harriet, I bet you I'ma carry it. I'm in love with music to the point I wanna marry it. But my love for people is greater, so I write messages. Largest spending power. Freedom. And justice.
What you gonna do with that dessert? Do what do I need that? What you gonna do with that dessert?